皆さんこんばんは、ハイディです。 Hi everyone, I'm Heidi。 今日はインターミディエットレッスンは、お疲れ様について行いたいと思います。 Today's intermediate lesson, I would like to introduce business Japanese phrases for work. お疲れ様です。お疲れ様です is a key phrase that you will need to master if you plan to work in a Japanese office. If you are starting your new job in Japan and you want to make sure that you develop a warm relationship with your new Japanese colleagues, the key expressions that you will have to learn is お疲れ様です。お疲れ様です。 In this お疲れ様、 you can find the root 疲れ which translates into be tired or to get tired. However, the meaning of expression is quite different. In the workplace, お疲れ様です expresses thatappreciation of your co-workers' hard work. The closest English translation would be, thank you for your hard work. Or more simple, saying, you worked hard. By saying, お疲れ様です, you show your appreciation for a colleague's work within your team or related to your company. So,When should I use お疲れ様? First of all, don't be embarrassed. It might sound strange to repeat it several times a day. Every time you see your coworkers. But for your colleagues, it shows your desire to get closer and to respect Japanese culture. So let's start with situation one, arriving at your workplace. In a situation when you would normally say hi or how are you to your colleagues, replace it withお疲れ様です。The expression is proper when you arrive at work after your colleagues. It's also a perfect conversation starter or ending, depends on the situation. For example, お疲れ様です。今日は早い出勤ですね。Hi, you arrived early at work today.
お疲れ様です。今日は早い出勤ですね。
Hi, you arrived early at work today. Let's move on to situation 2 in the workplace. You can use the expression in a wide range of situations. Very often,Internal meetings will end with everyone saying お疲れ様です as a way to thank all the participants. Co-worker will thank each other for the completion of a task or when one of them comes back from a meeting outside and say お疲れ様です expresses that importance of teamwork in Japan. For example,
お疲れ様、会議どうだった?
Hey, how was the meeting?
お疲れ様、会議どうだった?
Hey, how was the meeting? And let's move on to situation 3, after work. The phrase is typically used after working hours.When employees leave the office, the colleagues still working and say goodbye with お疲れ様です。お疲れ様でした。Sorry. For example, お疲れ様でした。お先に失礼します。Thank you for your hard work. I'm leaving now. お疲れ様でした。お先に失礼します。Thank you for your hard work. I'm leaving now. So, what is the difference between desu and deshita? Nuance is a bit tricky. When saying deshita, you use the past form and imply that the work is done or over. If you were to leave a colleague to his task and say deshita, for example, お疲れ様です。This is a present sentence, so you use this when you're arriving at work. And お疲れ様でした。でした is a past sentence, so you use this when you're leaving work. So, and sometimes you might hear and you might wonder, why does my boss tell me Gokuro-sama? Why does my boss tell me Gokuro-sama? The two expressions, Otsukare-sama and Gokuro-sama, share the same meaning, showing the appreciation of someone's effort. However, Gokuro-sama is less used because it is something a boss would say to their employees. Simply saying, your boss can thank you with Gokuro-sama, but you will answer back with a respectful Otsukare-sama desu. For example, Gokuro-sama, 今日も頑張ったね。お疲れ様です。ありがとうございます。Well done, good job today. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. And in a more casual context, and with your friends, you can simply use お疲れor お疲れ様 as well.So always keep in mind to be careful with the level of politeness of Japanese. When you're in doubt, use 敬語 desu and deshita to be polite. So that's all for today and お疲れ様でした。I hope you all enjoyed my lesson. If you have any question, please leave your comments and see you all next time. Bye!